On the other hand, Lund AGA has supported the judgment of conviction passed by the trial court and submitted that at the time of occurrence, the appellants were apprehended at the spot by the prize party who had no axe to grind against them, and therefore the conviction is unassessable and has to be affirmed. He further submitted that all the accused persons belong to a gang of dacoits and they have assembled at the spot with the intention to commit dacoity, and it is a case of preparation to commit dacoity, and therefore no clemency should be shown to the appellants, and the conviction and sentence are to be confirmed. Having heard learned counsel for the parties and after going through evidence available on the record, we would first like to mention that it is trite law for the prosecution to establish its case beyond all shadows of reasonable doubts. On the other hand, it is also settled legal proposition that only on the basis of the prosecution witnesses being a police personnel cannot constitute a reason to discard or discredit their testimonies. In the light of this cardinal principle, we find that PW1, PW2 and PW3 are all police witnesses of the prosecution, whereas the trial court was informed all above referred glaring illegalities and inconsistencies. The legal propositions required that it would have been examined with utmost care and cautious rather than accepting pedantic ignoring the criticism without any valid reasons. Now turning to evidence of the informant as well as the supporting prosecution witnesses, we find that it does not inspire confidence. During incident, not even a single shot was fired by the dacoits even when they were being changed. This itself is a very unnatural conduct which does not appeal to reason at all. In respect of the recovery of country-made pistol and other firearm weapon from the possession of accused, the evidence in that respect is also very incredible and does not inspire any confidence. The investigating officer did not examine the said weapon either himself or from an expert to verify whether they are in working condition or not. On overall analysis of the entire facts and circumstances of the case, it appears that in order to work out the previous dacoity case, these appellants were apprehended by the police for the best reasons known to them and were implicated in the present incident without there being any credible evidence against them. This quote from perusal of the recovery memo finds that incriminating material and illegal weapons does not bear the signature of accused on it. Although signature of an accused on the recovery memo is not the mandatory requirement of the law, it is only the signature of the witnesses which are necessarily required. But if the defense version is that the appellants accused were arrested and no such incriminating article or illegal weapons had been recovered from them, then it has got relevance in order to ensure the presence of the accused persons along with the witnesses on the spot.